Alright guys, Swarly here, and in today's video we're going to be playing with Fire Fist Ace. And he's really good, I like playing with him. He does a lot of damage, he could be really annoying to fight against. And I mean, you just gotta stay back and hopefully your teammates will stay in front of you so you can just shoot down the enemies from behind them. I liked playing with him. He felt like a not as good version of Skypiea Zoro. And the reason I'm saying that is, like, although against Skypiea Zoro, I would say Ace would win because of the type advantage and his, if you just use the first two hits of his basic attack, they both go in a straight line. And he can out damage the Skypiea Zoro. But other than that, Ace lacks speed. Skypiea Zoro can run away, Ace really can't. So when you fight an enemy that you're not gonna beat, like with Skypiea Zoro, you can run away, but with Ace, you can only run away so much before they'll catch up to you. Alright, so this got some meat. This croc was about to come up to me, and I don't know what was hitting me. Right, try to get this off real quick. Alright, hit them both with that, but only take down the Mihawk. And they just keep coming. Gosh. The Nami did perfect dodge that, so I figured I was gonna die anyways, because I wasn't gonna be able to run away from her since she's a runner. Alright, and yeah, I went a mono blue team just so I could make Ace a little stronger. It's always weird playing without a runner. Like without Skypiea Zoro or Law on my team. But it was alright. Kid's really good. Yeah, both of Ace's skills are really good. The skill 2 is kinda hard to land. It's more like situational. I always end up doing it whenever they were, like, whenever I'd knock them down from either the basic attacks or the skill 1. I would use it whenever they're waking up from being knocked down. And like when it hits the ground, it lingers there for a little bit. So most of the time they think you did it too early, but once their invincibility ends, it hits them. And his skill 2 is really strong. All right, so we were able to win that one. Five kills, pretty good. Looks like I forgot to cut that part out. Oh well. Right. I was using the Karubi and Arlong metal, so whenever I got a kill, I'd be able to get that critical boost, so I could do a lot more damage. I felt like I was gonna need that more than just the attack. Yeah, but Ace really needs good teammates to pretty much be there for you. To be in front of you, to push forward, and because your goal is gonna want to be to stand back. And yeah, I don't know why that runner went for the first flag. He should have gone to one of the farther ones, but oh well. I'm just laying some damage on this. Some little damage, because he got type advantage over me, so I'm not going to do too much. Alright, I threw that out there in case he ran towards me, because then it would have hit him. Alright, each of my shots was doing about 350 to 400, 500, so I wasn't doing too bad. And that was each little each little pellet. Like that one did 700. And he didn't want to finish me off, I guess. I guess his skill, he tried to use skill one already. I am able to take him out, and we got team boost. Dang, and just each of my shots were doing a pretty good amount of damage. Yeah, I like just using the first two shots of his basic attack. Like that. Especially if they're fighting someone else, like, it'll interrupt them from attacking your partner. So yeah, with him, you're going to want to like stand back, try to let your partners do some of the heavy lifting while you help them out. Going to chase him around. And going to throw that out there. See, like that, it lingers there, so it... Like, they think they're good, but they're not. But you need to be careful with that one, because, I mean, it doesn't nullify stagger, so you can just get jabbed out of it. Alright, last 30 seconds, we just need to defend. I got knocked down, so I need to make my little butt all the way back up here. Alright, we got three teammates right up here, so we're doing pretty good, but I was taken out. Telling my teammates to guard. Put on my gloves so I can run faster, but I'm not gonna make it up there in time. But my team did defend, so good job, everyone. Yeah, Ace counters the Sky Piazzoro really well, but the time skip Luffy is tough for Ace. Like, just he can't deal with the rush down from the Luffy. Then like Sanji and Enaru are tough for Ace to beat also. So watch out for those people. Alright, we got two red people on the opposite team, so we're gonna try to aim to attack those people. I'm gonna go up top. I stood right on the line so he wouldn't be able to pick up the flag. And just the enemy I wanted to fight, the red Luffy. He perfect dodged that because his thing, his invincibility was about right about to end, and I timed it good. Just he perfect dodged. I do not want to fight that Luffy, so I'm gonna try to keep going after this 30 million bounty Luffy. And unfortunately, the wall was there. Yeah, the rushdown's just too much. But I was able to kill him. I just kept shooting away. I don't know where the camera was looking at. Right. I stayed next to the bubble so I could have an easy escape route. But the Mihawk was coming right up for me, so I jumped back down. And I was able to one-shot him, but I died as well. I did finally get my kid up to 6-star. I had like I had over 200 of the 4-star fragments from like the season rewards and stuff, so I was just like, you know what, I'll treat myself. And he's stupid strong. Was able to take out the Luffy. I like the first hit of his basic attack, because like it hits farther than it looks like it. Like there's like an invisible hitbox on the front of it that it goes out a little farther than the actual like visually it looks. And, I mean, it does decent amount of damage with the glove on, so. Dang, I hit him for 27,000. And we were able to win that one. Alright guys, hope you enjoyed my video. Thanks for watching. Bye.